हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स. दिस इज चैप्टर 8, हाउ डू ऑर्गेनिज्म रिप्रोड्यूस. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द मेथड्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन एंड टाइप्स ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन, दैट इज ए सेक्सुअल एंड सेक्सुअल टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन एंड हाउ द रिप्रोडक्शन टेक्स प्लेस इन यूनिसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिज्म. ओके, सो लेट अस बिगिन. Now first of all, what the reproduction is. Reproduction is the process by which living organism produce new individuals of the same species. Again, reproduction is the process by which living organism produce new individual of the same species. Now the question is here, why the reproduction is important? Actually, there are so many life processes which you have already studied in your previous classes, like digestion, respiration, circulation, etc. But reproduction is not necessary life process. But again, reproduction is very necessary. Why it is necessary? For the survival and increase in the population of species. Because if the organism do not reproduce, their population decrease and ultimately what will happen, species will become extinct. Next, that what happens before reproduction. We all know that the nucleus, it contains DNA, and DNA means it contains chromosome, and that chromosomes, they are responsible for the transfer of characters from the parents to the offspring. Now these chromosomes, they bear genes which are responsible for transfer of characters. Now what happens during the reproduction process, these reproductive cells, they are present in the testes and ovary. Okay, so these reproductive cells, in case of plant cell, these reproductive cells are present in anther and ovule. So these reproductive cells, they undergo division, but before division they make two copies of DNA, be separate into two different cells. Now during DNA copying, the two DNA which are formed, they are not identical to each other, because whenever you go for copying a Xerox, what happens, you get the Xerox copy, photocopy, that is not 100% similar to the original one. In the same way, whenever DNA copies will takes place in both cells, the DNA, they are not exactly same, because no biochemical reaction is 100% reliable. So due to this, what happens in the new individuals, there is always slight variation from their parents. So whenever there is a new individual, actually that has some variation from its parents, because that individual is not exactly same like its parent. Due to this variation, due to error in DNA copying, and this variation is basis for the evolution of new species. Now the question is here, what is the importance of this variation? So this variation which are accumulating generation by generation, that variation help in survival of organism in the existing environment, because our environment is constantly changing due to changing in temperature, climate, water level, etc. So organism have to adjust itself in the changing environment, otherwise their species will extinct. So how the organism will able to survive in the environment, that is with the help of variation. So variation plays very important role. Again, one thing you have to keep in your mind, that these variation may not be benefit for individual, but it is very beneficial for the species. So variation is necessary for the survival of different species and for the evolution of new species. Now next we will talk about the different types of reproduction. So we all know that from our previous classes, in your previous classes, like in class 7, class 8, you have already gone through these chapters, that is the reproduction. So we know that the types of reproduction, actually there are two types of reproduction, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Now, what is the difference between these two, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction? Asexual reproduction, it is the type of reproduction in which only one parent is involved, that is it, the new individuals, they are produced from single parent. Whereas in case of sexual reproduction, it is the type of reproduction in which two individuals involved to produce a new individual, means there is requirement of two parents. Okay. So now in the coming slide we will see about the different types of asexual reproduction. So the different types of asexual reproduction are like fission, budding, regeneration, fragmentation, spore formation, vegetative propagation, etc. So there are so many types of asexual reproduction. Now we will see in detail. First is that fission. The word fission means to break. So first, this fission is of two types, that is binary fission and multiple fission. Binary means two. So binary fission, in the binary fission the organism divides and it forms two individual. Whereas in multiple fission the organism divides into many daughter cells. So here you have to remember the examples of binary fission and multiple fission. The best example for binary fission is division in amoeba. Amoeba divides into two individuals, two daughter amoebae, with the help of this binary fission. Whereas the plasmodium, you know that what the plasmodium is, it is malarial parasite which causes malaria. So plasmodium undergo multiple fission. It undergo multiple fission and it gives many daughter cells. Next is the budding method. So in this method the bud like projection is formed from the body of organism and this bud then develops into new individual. Okay, so budding method, it takes place in the yeast. You know that what the yeast is, it is a unicellular fungus, and it also takes, budding also takes place in Hydra. Just in picture you can see that here bud like structure grows and ultimately it detaches from the parent body and it lives its life. Next one is, that is regeneration. Regeneration is very important type of asexual method because it is taking place in Hydra, planaria and starfish, etc. Here the organism's body, it cut into many parts and each part has ability to regenerate. So this is the method of regeneration, in which the, if the organism is cut or broken, it can develop into new individuals. Next one is fragmentation, and this type of reproduction, it takes place in Spirogyra. You know what the Spirogyra is, it is a type of algae, thread like algae, and simply its body breaks into many smaller pieces, and on maturation these fragments develop into new individuals. So this fragmentation takes place in Spirogyra. And next one is, that is spore formation. Mostly it takes place in the fungi, different types of fungi like Rhizopus, Mucor, Penicillium, etc. So they have these sporangia have many tiny cells which are called as spores. Okay, when these spores, they come in contact with moist surface, ultimately it develops into new individuals. Now next one is vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation, it takes place in the plants. Actually plant part, it can be divided into two groups, that is reproductive part and vegetative part. Reproductive part is the flower, whereas all other part they are called as vegetative part. So whenever the reproduction takes place except flower, means that is with the help of root, with the help of stem or with the help of leaf, Such type of reproduction is called as vegetative propagation. Here you can see the various examples from your daily life that this is the leaf of bryophyllum. Here the new individual, that is new plant, comes from the notches of the leaves, whereas you can see many other examples like a rose plant in which the cutting takes place. Simply you cut the stem of rose plant and put it into the soil, it will regenerate, it develops into a new plant. So this is the method of vegetative propagation. Means whenever we are using different methods, means different parts of plant for reproduction other than flower, is called as vegetative propagation. Now next is that we will see how the sexual reproduction takes place in flowering plant. Before knowing the method of sexual reproduction in flowering plant, you must know the structure of flower. So whenever we go for the structure of flower, you see the different parts of the flower. In the flower, there are basically there are two parts, that is male part and female part. Male parts, they are called as stamens, whereas female part, it is called as pistil. This pistil is consist of three parts, that is stigma, style and ovary. Stigma, style and ovary. Whereas stamen, that is male part, again it consists of two parts, that is anther and filament. In anther, there is male reproductive part, or you can say that male reproductive gamete, which is called as pollen grain. Whereas in ovary, there is female reproductive organ, which is called as ovule, which has embryo sac, which involves in the reproduction. Okay, so anther produces male gamete, whereas ovary contains female gamete. So you must go through the structure of flower before proceeding further for sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Now what happens, you know that what happens actually, the anther produces pollen grains. Now these pollen grains, they have to be transferred from anther to the stigma of flower. Now the process, this process is called transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma is called as pollination. Now this pollination, it takes place with the help of various agencies like wind, water, insect, etc. Okay, and this pollination, it is of two types, that is self pollination and cross pollination. If the pollen grains, they are transferred from anther to the stigma of same flower, then it is called as self pollination. And if the anther means pollen transfer from anther to the stigma of another flower, it is called as cross pollination. Okay, so now what is pollination? Pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma. It is of two types, that is self pollination and cross pollination. Now next, what happens when the pollination takes place? The pollen grains, they land on the stigma. The pollen grains, they land on the stigma of the female reproductive part. On this stigma, these pollen grains, they germinate and they form pollen tube. They form pollen tube. This pollen grains has two male gametes called as, in this figure you can see that it is called as tube nucleus and generative nucleus. So this pollen tube, it contains two male gametes called as generative nucleus and tube nucleus. And if you see the structure of ovule, inside the ovule there is embryo, which contains a total number of 8 cells. 3 cells are called as antipodal cells, and these below 3 cells, in these 3 cells 2 are called as synergids and 1 is the female egg, and 2 more cells are there inside the at the center of embryo, which is called as polar nuclei. Now we will see what happens. Now what happens when the pollen grain land on the stigma, it germinates into a pollen tube, which contains two male gametes one is called as generative and second one is called as tube nucleus. Ultimately this pollen tube, it enters into the embryo sac, whereas one nucleus fuses, one male gamete fuses with the female gamete and other fuses with the polar nuclei. So the fusion of male gamete with female gamete, you know that this process is called as fertilization. Ultimately it forms zygote. So zygote is the first structure after fertilization, that when male gamete fuses with female gamete, it forms zygote, and this zygote further develops into embryo, and embryo matures to form the seed, whereas the second male gamete fuses with the polar nuclei and it forms endosperm, which is used as a nutrient. So one more question is here, one more term is here, that is double fertilization. So we have two male gametes, one fuses with female gamete and other fuses with polar nuclei, so two fusions are taking place at a time, that's why it is called as double fertilization. So thank you, that's all.